NBA star Rick Fox was a big part of the Lakers championship seasons alongside Kobe Bryant and Shaquille O'Neal. He was the most passionate player on the squad. When he stepped on the court, he gave 100% every night. I caught up with him to see what has he been up to these days and what was it like being a player who played both for the Celtics and the Lakers. How does he compare fans in both camps?
Hey, how are you?
Good. What up, man?
First of all,
yeah,
you're an actor.
I'm an actor.
You're a player.
I'm a player.
You're a color commentator.
Color commentator.
Where do you have time to breathe?
In between, fourth quarter.
So first of all, Rick, you look like you can still play.
Looks are deceiving. It's all smoke and mirrors, baby. It's all how I cut the uniform nowadays. Real baggy.
So what do you say about the Lakers this year?
They look good, don't they? I like that they seem to have a little edge about them, as they obviously took it on the chin last year in the NBA Finals, and they want to get back. They beat two very, very good teams in Cleveland and Boston last week on the road. So, you know, Bynum's return hopefully in 2 months could be very helpful. But I don't know if they're set on losing this year. I think they're determined to win.
Seems like they're playing with the Rick Fox intensity.
Well, you know what? You know, that sometimes is a little out of control, as we all know, but better to rein that in than to not have it at all. So I like them to play with a little more emotion and physicality.
When you play like this, do you miss playing the crowd, the fans, the excitement?
That was fun. Today was fun. I don't miss it because I can't do it at the level I used to do it at, and that's obviously you know, when you've done it for 20 years, it's obviously frustrating to see it go by the wayside, do more to physical inabilities than mental. So, you know, I can be a fan. I know I can do that. I am a fan of the game still.
You were a former Celtic, and then you became a Laker. How do you compare fans in both camps? Because they're both very...
They're both fanatical. They both love their teams. They love their tradition, their history. Both squaring off last year, obviously, electrified basketball again. Hopefully that's a repeat performance this year.
Yeah, so what have you been up to these days besides all the work?
What have I been up to? I mean, I'm on television, on the show, TV show The Game. Tonight, actually, it's probably going on right now, 8:30 on CW. I produce a couple things. I have two TV shows.
You got a special role that you'd like to play sometime?
I do, but I don't think anybody would hire me for it.
What's that?
I want to play Bob Marley, but...
Speaking of which,
yeah.
Rick, if they made a movie about you, who do you think will play you best?
Well, it seems like Will Smith plays every leading African-American man in the world. I mean, he played Ali, he can play Obama, he could play, you know, so. I don't know, hopefully I have a little more to put to the story over the next few years to have somebody play me.
Speaking of which, how did your Obama project work out? You went on the bus, you did the tour?
Yeah, well, we're just editing it right now. Got a couple places that want it, so you want to make sure that it's ready and right, and it tells the right story.
Did you meet the president?
I have not met him yet, but that's a part of the documentary.
After all this?
Not yet. It's okay.
On the basketball court, center court, one-on-one.
For my citizenship, I'll take it.
Wouldn't that be a game, Rick Fox against Barack Obama? I'll be watching that one. In Los Angeles, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.